Ayan, good morning everyone. Parang puyat pa kayo, ha? Good morning po. Amen. Sige nga po, bigyan po natin palakpak ang ating Panginoon. Amen. And amen. Are you blessed to be in God's house today? Amen. And ngayon po, sigurado ng Christmas Day na ngayon at pakibati naman ang iyong katabi ng Merry Merry Christmas. Amen. Nag-enjoy ba kayo kagabi? Maraming kainan, saluhan. Po tayong parties last week and ngayon po talagang sineselebrate lang natin ang goodness ng Panginoon para sa ating buhay. And you know what? It's just good to start our day with the Lord. It's just good na on a Christmas day, nandito po tayo sa simbahan ng Panginoon and we just love to celebrate God's goodness in our lives. Amen po ba dun? Amen. Once again, could just give God our very best praise, clap offering. Hallelujah. And today, are you excited to hear God's word? And I'm also excited to share with you God's word. Sino ba nandito last week? Nandito po kayo last week. Na-enjoy nyo ba at na-bless ba kayo sa presence ni Lord last week? And we really felt God's presence, God move in this place. Nandito po tayo lahat sa altar. And wow, just a wonderful experience of God's presence. At ngayon po ba, do you want to experience God again? Amen. And gusto nyo ba ma-experience si Lord ulit? Amen. Sige po, palakpakan po natin si Lord dyan. But before we continue, may papakita muna akong picture. So ano po ba tong picture na yan? Ano pong tawag dyan? Turtle. And when we look at a turtle, ano pong unang naiisip natin? It's slow, di ba? Talagang mabagal po ang isang turtle. At since we were kids, that's what we believed in. This is our perspective. A turtle is very slow. But what if I tell you na hindi pala totoo yun? Maniniwala po ba kayo? Parang hindi ka pinipaniwala, di ba? Kasi for all our years, ako mismo, for all my years, I believe that a turtle is one of the slowest animals that ever lived. Pero I would like to share you a video na nagpapakita kung talaga bang mabagal ang isang turtle. Sige nga po, let's play the slide right now. Bihira, we have been fooled all our lives na yung turtle pala, pag nilagay mo dyan sa sahig, talagang mabagal siya. Pero pag nilagay mo pala sa isang treadmill, wow, kaya naman niya pala magmabilis sa buhay. So sino po ba yung mga late? Pakitanong nga yung katabi mo ngayon, late ka ba ngayon? So pag nilagay pala sa treadmill yan, pag na-no choice siya, magmamadali din palang maligo at umalis ng bahay. Yan po. So sa atin, alam niyo po, marami na po tayong perspective sa lives. Marami na po tayong pinaniwalaan. Some of us here are at our 20s, at our 30s, 40s. We believe so many things already. We clinged on to our own perspective. Sometimes the world's perspective. Kaya lang as we cling on to the world's perspective, sometimes we forget and don't get the true meaning of life. So I would like to lead you in God's word in Matthew chapter 18, verse 1, and it says here, "At that time, the disciples came to Jesus saying, 'Who then is the greatest in the kingdom of heaven?'" Why? Because at this time, the disciples saw what Jesus did already in their lifetime. So all the things that they've believed in, all the things na sinabi nilang, ay, hindi pwede yan, hindi mangyayari yan. When Jesus came in their lives, at this time, pambihira, all the miracles really happened in their lives. Lahat ng imposible, naging posible po when Jesus came. So what they're asking right now, "Yes, Lord, I believe in you already. This is what we've gone through as we followed you. Right now, Lord, who is the greatest in the kingdom of heaven?" Kingdom of heaven meaning, in your perspective, God, I want your perspective right now already. Lord, who is the greatest in the kingdom of heaven? Siyempre po tayo, we're gonna end our year already. At siyempre, di ba, we want to finish strong. Amen po ba dun? We want to finish great. We want to finish strong. We want to finish properly. And paano ba? Gusto natin makamit po yun at the last days of our year, we want to make it great. Para po pagpasok ng next year, wow, the best is yet to come. And alam niyo po, last week po, I was having these struggles in my mind. Why? Because I was thinking about this week. Ano po ba? I'm gonna will I give my last hurrah already? Ibig sabihin, I'm gonna go evangelism still, do some fellowships, go to some parties. Lahat, tatrabaho pa ba ako for the church? Last hurrah? Or will I just, take it easy na lang? So dalawa po, will I give my last hurrah or take it easy? Hindi ko po maintindihan. Hindi ko po alam ang leading ng Lord for me. So ganun din po ang na-experience po ng mga disciples. But ito po yung sinabi ni Jesus in verse 2, it says, "Then Jesus called a little child to him, set him in the midst of them." So he called just like this little child. So ganyan po siya. So cute po ba yung little child? So sabi ni Jesus, parang this is my example. You want to be the greatest? Look at this little child. So if I were the disciples, yes, Lord, this child, she may be the cutest child I've ever seen in my life, but Lord, I don't think that he's the greatest. I don't think, Lord, are you serious that this kid is great? I don't see anything extraordinary. She's just cute. She may be the cutest, but maybe not the greatest. So are you serious, Lord? Are you really telling me to be like this little child? And Jesus was telling the people, was telling the disciples, yes, I'm really serious. Look at this little child. This little child I've set before you in the midst of the people, in the midst of the disciples. Look at him. And what would this little child do? If he were in our position right now, sa panahon po ngayon, ano kayang gagawin ng little child na to? Ibibigay niya ba yung last hurrah niya or take it easy? Diba? Hindi natin alam ano kayang gagawin ng isang little child. So habang nag-iisip po tayo, para mas mapag-isipan po natin, hindi tayo mahirapan, tayo po muna ay mag-pray ngayon. Okay po ba yun? Amen. Sige po, let us bow our heads and let us pray today. Hallelujah, Lord Jesus Christ. Thank you for this wonderful Sunday. Lord God, thank you, Lord God, for bringing in your people here. Lord God, they didn't come here for me. Lord God, they didn't come here for the place. Lord God, they came here for you, Lord God. Only your presence, Lord God, is just so heaven to us. And Lord God, this is a great privilege that on a Sunday, Lord God, at December 25, exactly Sunday, Lord God, we're celebrating it in your house. And Lord God, today, Lord God, we just ask for your anointing. Lord God, we ask for your wisdom. We ask for your favor and just flow in our midst today. Lord God, we don't want to impress here, Lord God, but we just want to praise you in our lives today. Lord God, we claim the victory and we give you back all the glory and all the praise in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Everybody shout, amen and amen. Sige po, palakpakan po natin ang ating Panginoon. Amen and amen. And you know what, when I was still a little child, you know what, I don't care about giving my last hurrah. I don't care about giving my, on the last days of Christmas, bibigay ko yung best ko. I don't care about that. I dwell on how to take life easy. I don't care about pacing my life. Ang gusto ko lang po gawin, nung bata po ko, ang gusto ko lang mangyari ay magtapos na ng school. I want the school to end para po ako po ay makapaglaro na, makapagkaroling na, makasama ko yung mga friends ko. And you know what, when I was a child, all about was receiving gifts. Di ba po, sino po yung mga bata pa dito? Na-miss niya po yung pagkabata. Bakit po kasi nung tayo po ay tumanda na, parang anyari. Di ba? Parang wala na nagbibigay ng regalo. Nung child tayo, nung mga children tayo, ang dami nating gifts, pero habang tumatanda, nawawala na po sila. At alam niyo po, when I was a child, all I follow was my parents. Bakit po? Because I have faith in them that when I'm with them, I'm just gonna follow them and it's just gonna be fun. Hindi po ako mapapahamak. It's gonna be safe with my parents wherever they are, when we're in a mall, hotel, wherever we are. I have faith that it's gonna be all right. And that's what God is telling us right now, when Jesus is telling us, look, disciples, look at this child. At ano bang pinapakita ni Jesus sa atin doon? Look at his childlike faith. Childlike faith ng bata. Why? Because ang isang child na may faith, alam niyo po, a little child believes that everything's gonna be okay. Tama po ba yun? Ang isang bata, sa may mga anak po dito, 3 years old, 4 years old, 5 years old, ang bata po na yan, walang pakialam po yan sa mundo. Wala po yung pakialam sa mga kasama niya. Ang pinaniniwalaan lang niya, he has faith that everything's gonna be alright. That's the child. And in the next verse, in Matthew 18, verse 3, it says here, Jesus said, "Assuredly, I say to you, unless you are converted and become as little children, you will by no means enter the kingdom of heaven. So when I was reading this, Lord, parang ang bigat naman. Lord God, pag hindi kami na-convert as a little child, Lord, hindi kami makakapasok sa heaven. Lord, paano yun? Paano kami, Lord? Hindi na ako babata ulit. Diba? How we wish, diba? Sa mga 60s na nandito man. Diyan yung mga 60s natin. How we wish na tayo po ay bumata po ulit. Pero paano ba yun? Ano po ba yung pinapa-convert ni Jesus sa atin? Why? Because in our time today, in our generation today, in this world today, we are tremendous warriors. Pakitanong nga yung katabi mo, ikaw ba yan? Diba? We worry so much. We worry about our lives. We worry about the lives of other people. We worry about tomorrow. We worry about next week. Hindi pa po tapos yung 2016. Nako, inisip na natin yung December 2017. Diba? We worry so much about our lives, our work, business, family, all these things. But what does the Bible tell us about worry? Sabi po sa Matthew chapter 6, verse 31 to 32, it says here, "So do not worry, saying, what shall we eat? Or what shall we drink? Or what shall we wear?" Dami nating iniisip, dami nating worry. "For the pagans run after all these things, and your heavenly Father knows that you need them." So pag tayo pala ay worry ng worry about the material things of this world, if we worry and worry about our lives, about our family, about our future, ano po nangyayari? Nile-level po natin yung sarili natin with the pagans. At sino po ba yung mga pagans? They are the people who don't believe in God. People who doesn't have faith in God, who just believes in themselves, and there's no God. Kaya pala, hindi tayo makakapasok sa langit kapag kasing level lang natin yung mga pagans. Kaya sinasabi ni Lord, be converted and don't be like the pagans. Don't be warriors. Why? Because childlike faith. Ano ba ang nagagawa ng isang childlike faith? Why? Because when we worry, we think that we are fighting a battle. Akala po natin, kakaka-worry po natin, lumalaban po tayo ng patas. But the real thing is when we worry, pambihira, we're actually losing the battle. But with childlike faith, ito pong ginagawa ng childlike faith, it makes you warriors and not worriers. Amen po ba dun? You are made warriors, not worriers. Lalo na po sa point na when we have faith kasi, akala natin we're already in the losing side. Pero after everything that we've done, after we have put our faith in God, pambihira, everything just converts and changes at tayo na po ang nasa winning side. Amen po ba dun? Amen, because of faith, the childlike faith. At ano po ba? Minsan po kasi, as we worry, we think we're praising God. When we worry, we think we're doing it for other people. I'm doing sobrang stress na po tayo sa house. Sobrang worryful tayo about our family, about our work, about our business. We thought we're doing it, all the stress, all the emotions, we think we're doing it for the family, for other people, but little did we know, we're just doing it for our own selves. Kaya po, when we have the childlike faith, wow, it makes you a worshiper, not a warrior. Amen po ba dun? Amen. And lastly, sa atin po, minsan po, as we worry, we think forward. We think we're running forward. Kala po natin may nangyayari sa kaka-worry po natin. But the reality is, hindi pala tayo gumagalaw. We're not even moving. But when we have this childlike faith, wow, it makes you a water walker and not a worrier. Amen po ba dun? Amen. Sige nga po, palakpangan po natin ang ating Panginoon. And naalala ko po, ito seryoso po to, nakakahiyaman, but when I was a kid, may swimming pool kasi kami dito sa Merville. Alam niyo po, isang pong pina-practice ko po, paano maglakad sa tubig. Nasubukan niyo na po ba 'yon? So pina-practice niyo po ba 'yon? So ako kasi may faith na kaya ko rin lumakad sa tubig. Di ba? Kaya ko rin 'yan. So pina-practice ko siya nung bata ako. Siguro kung hindi po ako tumanda, na perfect ko na po 'yon. Nakakalakad na ako sa tubig ngayon. But the thing is, wow, nothing is impossible for our God. And whatever you're going through today, nothing is impossible when you have
faith. Amen po ba dun?
Amen. And do you want this faith? Do you want this childlike faith? And this, the disciples were telling Jesus, yes, Lord, I want this faith. I want this. How do I get this? And it says in Matthew chapter 6, verse 33, it says here, but seek first the kingdom of God and His righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you.
Amen po ba tayo dyan?
Just put God first. Just put Him above everything else. Just seek Him first. Just have faith in Him. And everything's gonna be alright for your life. At ano po ba yung, how did we do it in our church? How did we translate this in our church in putting God first? Kung maalala niyo po yung ating each one, bring one commitment. So sino po dito ang dinala ang kanyang friends for this month? So meron po tayo dyan. So marami po nagdala. So hindi ba kayo nabibless na marami tayo ngayon? Amen. Ang dami po natin yan. It's such a blessing. And when we did this, we're telling God, Lord, not in our own strength, not in our own might, I just want to put you first. And Lord God, it will eat up some of my time. But ikaw na bahala sa business ko, ikaw na bahala sa work ko, ikaw na bahala sa family ko, I just want to put you first. And may nangyari, ating each one bring one commitment. Tingin niyo po, may nangyari? Amen, di ba? And I would just like to show you the comparison. This is our graph. So just focusing on December 2015 to 2016. December 2015 and only December 2016. And you know what? Our attendance last year, December 2015, our average was 127. So that's usually our average. Nasa 120s, 130s ang ating church attendance. But because we had put God first, we had sought God first, we had faith in Him. You know what? Sa pagpasok pa lang ng December, first week of December ng 2016, this is our growth. Tayo po ay lumago ng 150 members po. Sige po, parang nalungkot po kayo ha. Sige po, pwede po natin ipalakpak yan sa Panginoon. First Sunday, and we are really blessed. I'm really happy, I'm really blessed to see this graph. And usually, kapag alam niyo po, pag nag-hit po tayo ng career high sa ating attendance, usually, the next Sunday po, babagsak na po yan. Pag tinignan niyo po yung mga graphs natin, usually mag-130 na ulit yan, 120, balik na sa average. But you know what? On the next Sunday, on the second Sunday, this is what happened. We grew to 160 attendance. Amen. Palakpakan po natin si Lord dyan. And God is really moving. At alam niyo po, when we just put our faith in Him, di ba, syempre nalulungkot tayo pag onti tayo dito. Amen po ba dun? Di ba, we want na marami tayo dito, mas marami makakilala sa Panginoon, and Jesus wants that for us as well. And usually, okay na to Lord. This is a miracle. Two consecutive streaks na mataas tayo. Pero si Lord, hindi pa po nagtapos. Pinataas niya pa po ng isa sa third Sunday po natin. So, 161 tayo. Di ba? So, talagang, bigay na ni Lord, isa lang. Pero pambihira, hindi niya papababain eh. Di ba? Para may storya tayo. Winning streak, three-week streak, pero pambihira. Tignan niyo naman yung sa likod niyo. Tignan niyo yung katabi niyo ngayon. I believe today we are more than 160. Amen po ba dun? Amen. Sige po, palakpakan po natin ang ating Panginoon. Wow, on a December, the house is full. The church of God is full. Why? Because God is moving. Amen po ba dun? Amen. Sige nga po, palakpakan po ulit natin siya. And that's what childlike faith does for us. It makes you warrior, worshiper, a water walker. And sometimes kasi, we try to equate faith with fear. Parang lumalaki yung fear sa ating buhay. But you know what? Natatakot kasi tayo ibigay yung unahin lang si Lord kasi natatakot tayo. But you know what? Faith is not equal to fear. Why? Because faith erases all and leads you to follow God. And nothing is impossible for our God. And He will move in our church. He will move in our lives today. Amen. Sige po, bigay po natin yan para sa Panginoon today. Hallelujah, Lord. Thank you. And because God is moving, naniniwala po ba kayo that God is moving in this place? God is moving in our lives. And because of that, we have something to thank for sa ating Panginoon. Amen po ba yun? Meron ka bang gustong ipasalamat sa Panginoon ngayon? Parang wala tayong ipapasalamat. Meron po ba tayong ipapasalamat kay Lord? Amen. At yan po sinasabi ni Lord when Jesus was telling the disciples, look at this child. Look intricately at this child and look at his
childlike thanksgiving. Ayan po nangyayari po sa atin. So pag tayo po ba nakita po natin tong glass po na ito. So what do you see with this glass? So ano po ba yan? Is this half full or half empty? Sa tingin niyo po, kasi syempre nasa gitna po yung water. So it's either half full, sabi ni nung bata, half full. So very ano siya, very confident siya na half full or half empty. So sino po nagsasabi na half full? So, may half full. Sino naman nagsasabi na half empty? The same. So, sabi po dun sa study, sabi po sa research, kapag sinabi po pala natin na ito po, ang tingin po natin dito ay half full, we have a positive outlook in life. Nakikita po natin na, wow, onti na lang mapupuno na. So, we are optimist. We have a positive perspective in life. But when we say it's half empty, tayo po pala ay mga pessimist. Na ang lagi natin nakikita, nako, kulang na, it's not enough. Nako, ano, mauubusan na tayo, problema to. So, ganun po pala kapag nakikita po natin siyang ganun. It's either you're half full na optimist or half empty na nakikita po natin. At usually, ito po tayo sa buhay po natin. Usually, nakikita po natin yung mga pangit ng buhay. Nakikita po natin yung mga kakulangan natin, yung mga hindi natin nakakamit. Sometimes po, ang sagot po natin dito ay half empty. But, I tell you the truth, pag ito pong baso na to ay binigay mo sa isang bata, pambihira. Wala siyang pakialam kung half full yan o half empty. Ang kailangan niya lang gawin ay inumin yan dahil nauuhaw siya. Kailangan niya ng water. At anong sasabihin niya pag tinanong natin, what will you say? Diba? Para tayong childlike na tayo. Childlike Thanksgiving na yan, diba? So, pag binigay po natin sa child, it doesn't matter half full, half empty, I'm just gonna give my thanks. Thank you for the water that you give me. And you know what? It also happened in John chapter 6, verse 9. And it says here, there is a lad here who has 5 barley loaves and 2 fish. So in this situation, you know this story, when Jesus fed the 5,000 people, and before that, Jesus made miracles in their time, but it came to a point na wala po silang mapakain. For a large crowd, 5,000 men were in front of them, and the disciples wanted to shoo them away. Palayasin na natin sila, wala tayong kayang ipakain. But Jesus tell them, what do we have? So meron po silang pinakita, lumapit po yung isang bata na meron pala siyang 5 loaves and 2 fish. At alam niyo po, yung paglapit ng bata na yun, ito po yung siguro itsura niya, nagdadala siya ng bread kay Jesus. Hi Jesus, Lord, I have some bread for you. So, ang cute ng bata, di ba? So, siguro ang nasa isip niya, Lord, may magagawa kaya to, Lord? Basta, Lord, gusto ko itong ibigay sa'yo. It's very special to me. Kakainin ko sana yan, pero Lord, ibibigay ko na sa'yo. Sa'yo na ang aking tinapay. What could you do with it, Lord? At siguro po, baka unfair po, wala pong isda. So, meron din po akong picture ng bata na may isda. So, ganyan po itsura niya. So, mas malaki pa yung isda sa mukha niya, di ba? So he went to Jesus, the child with 5 loaves and 2 fish presented himself to Jesus, Lord, this is my 5 loaves and 2 fish, Lord. And Lord, I believe that this 5 loaves and 2 fish could do something for us today. Lord, I know this is enough, and Lord, I just entrust it to you. But here are the adults. And dito yung mga disciples, pumasok na naman yung mga disciples and said in the next verse, but what are they among so many? Sabi nila kay dun sa bata, sabi nila kay Jesus, Lord, are you kidding me? 5 loaves and 2 fish. Lord, we're not even half empty. Lord, we're really, literally empty, empty, just 1%. How could this 5 loaves and 2 fish feed 5,000 people? Lord, kulang yan. Lord, kailangan natin bumili. Kailangan natin, Lord, tawagan na yung Shakey's. Buy one, take one. Mas makakatibid tayo dun. Lord, gawan na natin ang paraan. Lord, 5 loaves and 2 fish. Walang mangyayari dyan. And you could just feel their emotion. Why? Sino po ba dito ang mga naghanda kagabi? May mga nag-host ba ng party last night, Christmas Eve? And you could just feel the pressure. You could just feel the intensity na, alam mo yun, gusto mo magpakain ng tao. Kaya lang, nung sa pagpapakain nila, akala na enough. Pero pambihira, 5,000 yung dumating. How are we gonna feed them? So it was a shameful experience. It was a shameful crisis for the disciples and Jesus, and they don't know what to do. That's the atmosphere. It's a losing atmosphere. Lord, alisa tayo, Jesus, Lord. Mapapahiya tayo dito, hindi natin kaya pakiin ng 5,000. But this is what Jesus did in verse 11. It says here, and Jesus took the loaves. Pwede ko bang makita yung tinapay mo? Let everybody sit down. Chill lang kayo. Steady lang kayo. Give me the loaves. And guess what happened? What happened after that? Ano po nangyari sa loaves and the fish? Ano po yun? It multiplied. But before it multiplied, what did Jesus do with it? What did Jesus do with it before it was multiplied? This is what Jesus did. You know what he did? He gave thanks. With what he has, Jesus was really setting that example na it doesn't matter if it's half empty, half full, or it doesn't matter if it's almost empty, really literally empty, wala nang mangyayari dyan. Whatever you're going through right now, in your emptiness of your life right now, in your nothingness of your life right now, you could still give thanks. You could still give thanks. And what happens when we give thanks? What happened in the next verse? It says, he distributed them to his disciples. Lord, paano nangyari yun? 5 loaves, 2 fish, 7, 12 yung disciples mo. Paano nangyari yun? Pero may na-distribute siya sa bawat isa. Not only that, and the disciples to those sitting down, the 5,000 men were sitting down all over the place. At they were just amazed. They were just amazed that they were giving, giving, giving. And what happened to the fish? Likewise of the fish, as much as they wanted. With a heart of giving thanks, there was a miracle. God does something when we know how to give thanks. And you know what? People who are thankful change the atmosphere. Today, you may be in a dry atmosphere. You may be in a losing atmosphere. You might be right now in an empty atmosphere. But give thanks and watch what Jesus can do in your life today. Amen po ba dun? Amen. Sige po, palakpakan po natin ang Panginoon as an act of thanksgiving to God. And I want to make a confession for all of you. You know what, when I was starting this church, you know what, in the first few months, you know what, I've been envious of mega churches. Kasi po nung ako po ay nasa Dasma, I'm the youth head there in Church of God, Dasmanias, I was so envious about the churches here in Manila. Lord, ang laki na ng youth ministry nila. Lord, ang init ng mga youth ministry nila. Lord, ang laki na ng church nila. Bago na naman yung building ng isang church. Lord, binibless mo na naman sila. Lord, kami naman. Lord, I have been looking at other people, other churches, envious. Yun po nangyari. And then when I came here in church, I started Church of God, Marriott Manila here. Thank you to the Lord. Now, once again, I've been envious naman of Church of God, Dasmarinas. Lord, ang laki na ng Church of God, Dasmarinas. Lord, 13,000 people. Lord, kami nasa 100 plus pa lang. Thank you, Lord. 161 kami last Sunday. Diba? Thank you for that one soul na pinarating mo. One soul talaga, di ba? And Lord, I've been envious of other people. And you know what? When we be envious, look at other people. Look at how empty we are. How empty, how kulang our church is. Wow. We miss something very important. And it is to give thanks. We miss to give thanks. Wow. Oh, nga, nung ganda pala nung place natin ngayon. Wow. We are at Marriott Hotel Manila. Right? Andito tayo. Wow. Amazing. And I would less like to think this opportunity for the workers who are here in our church. You know what? Ako po ang nagli-lead ng church po na ito. Pero ako po ay may absent. Alam niyo naman po yan. Minsan po wala po ako dito. Pero meron po tayong workers since day one. Wala pa pong absent till today. And wow, I just want to thank. Sige, palakpakan po natin sila. Thank you for your commitment. Thank you for your support. Thank you for being here. May mga tao po tayo, 3 a.m. in the morning, hahakutin po nila yung gamit and lalagay po nila yan dito para po may tugtog tayo, may sounds tayo. Thank you. Thank you for your life. Thank you for the workers of this church. And thank you for the people who are here. You know what? You don't come here for me, but it's a joy for me to see all of you. And I thank you. For on a Sunday, we go here every Sunday. Wow. I would love to thank each and every one of you today. At alam niyo po, nandito rin po ang aking family. Siguro po minsan nakakalimutan natin pasalamatan ng ating family. Thank you to my family who is here right now. Na salamat po sa inyong support. Thank you very much for your support for 25 years of my life. And minsan po kasi sa ating families, minsan po madalas po nakikita po natin yung emptiness, yung brokenness, yung kakulangan, yung mga inis, yung mga emotions all around. And minsan, nakakalimutan na po natin magpasalamat. Kaya kung katabi mo po yung family member mo, katabi mo yung friend mo ngayon, pakisabi naman, thank you sa buhay mo. Amen. Amen. So yun po, marami po tayong alam, marami po tayong naisip, pero just like a child daw, sabi ni Jesus, in Matthew 18:4, it says here, therefore, whoever humbles himself as this little child is the greatest in the kingdom of heaven. Marami na po tayong alam for so many years, tadabuhay tayo, 20 years, 50 years, and all. Pero, minsan sa kadami ng kaalaman natin, we try to do things in our strength. Lagi natin nakikita yung half-empty ng buhay natin. But sabi ni Lord ngayon, pwede mo bang i-let go na yan? Pwede bang tsaka na yan? Bigyan muna natin siya ng ating thanksgiving. Amen po ba yun? Amen. Kaya kung tayo po ay nagpapasalamat sa Kanya, pwede ba natin ibigay yung ating best clap offering for Him? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And when we have this childlike faith, when we have this childlike thanksgiving, we get to learn how to give our childlike praise. We give our childlike praise to God. Why? Because usually, we praise God when everything's okay. The work is good, family is good, school is good, everything's good. Yes, I come to church, I'll praise. But there are times, most of the time, we're not okay. In the whole year, diba? Ang daming panahon na hindi tayo okay. Hirap mag-praise. Hirap sumimba. But, minsan din, usually, we praise when we are full. When we are full of joy, when we're full of thanksgiving, when we're full of love, full of hope, full of everything. Kaya lang pag dumating po tayo sa unos, sa bagyo, na empty po tayo, nauubusan po tayo, wow. Minsan, hindi na tayo makapag-praise. Hindi na natin mataas yung kamay natin and say, Lord Jesus, I praise you whatever is going through in my life today. But just like a child daw, just like a child. So ano ba tong child na to? This is, we could really learn so much from a child. Because this is how a child looks like. And this is how he praises. Panoorin po natin tong video na ito. And I don't understand a thing that he said there using a sign language. But one thing is that what I understood with this kid, he's saying, I'm deaf. I'm mute. I'm an orphan. I have so many friends out there, kids, with no parents out there. This is my situation. This is my crisis. But I don't care. I'm gonna praise. I'm gonna pray with all my heart. I don't care about my disease. I don't care about my sickness. I don't care about my handicap. I don't care if I'm deaf, if this is my situation. I don't care. I'm gonna praise Jesus. I'm gonna thank Him for the food that, because I have faith that everything's gonna be okay. And Jesus says, in verse 5, it says, whoever receives one little child like this in my name receives me. If you just receive it, you know what? There's more to life. There's more to learn from a child. Akala natin, bata lang yan eh. Walang matututunan dyan. Mas magaling ako dyan. But if you receive what this child is teaching, you're actually receiving me, says the Lord. Why? Because there was a certain woman who had a flow of blood for 12 years. And I could not relate to that. Diba? For that flow of blood of that woman, I could not relate to that. The 12 years of flow of blood, whatever that is. But what I could relate to is, she has been an outcast for 12 long years. Why? Because according to the law of the Israel, if you are flowing with blood, you are unclean, you are dirty, the people should not receive you, the people should not get near you because you're dirty, you're unclean. And she was experiencing that, being an outcast for 12 long years. 12 long years. That's why in the next verse he said, and had suffered from many things, from many physicians. You just could see how she begged for mercy for the physicians, for the doctors. Hey, doctor, I know I'm sick. I know I'm dirty. I know you should not receive me. I know you should not attend to me because of what I'm going through. But doctor, I need help. I need help. I don't know how to be cured. And you know what? She had spent all that she had and was no better, but rather grew worse. She gave it all, her money, her life, maybe her soul, everything she gave, but everything just grew worse and worse and worse. And when that happens for 12 years, what do we do? For 12 long years, it doesn't get better. 12 long years, it's just full of suffering, full of bullies, full of persecution. I'm unclean, I'm dirty, I'm like this. What do we do? But this woman heard about Jesus. Hey, this Jesus. He healed the sick out there. He blessed the people out there. He fed the 5,000. Oh, really? What? Wow, maybe this is my solution. And when she heard that Jesus was coming in front of her house, I can't miss this moment. So she came behind him in the crowd and touched his garment, for she said, if only I may touch his clothes, I shall be made well. Okay, I don't care, 12 years had suffered. I don't care, there are so many people. I have so many friends in front of there. But I don't care. I'm gonna praise. I'm gonna go to Jesus. I'm gonna pray. I'm gonna thank him. I believe I'm gonna be healed today because Jesus is here already. I'm not gonna miss this moment. And you know what? Guess what? Guess what happened? Immediately. As in, immediately. The fountain of her blood was dried up and she felt in her body that she was healed from her affliction for 12 long years. Just because she praised. All those sickness, all those defeat, all those persecution, all those crazy things ended immediately. And experience the power of God. Wow. And then what happened? And Jesus, immediately knowing in himself that the power had gone out of him, turned around in his crowd and said, who touched me? There's something different today. Someone touched me. I know it. I feel it. I know it in my heart. I felt it in my body. Healing went out of me. Something different went out of me. Who touched me? He was looking for someone who praised him, but the disciples, here comes the adults again, the perspective of the world, who said, you see the multitude thronging you and you say, who touched you? Lord, hundreds of people here, thousands of people here, and you say, who touched you? Of course everybody touched you. Of course, we were being pushed around. There's so many people out here who needs you, who's asking for your healing, and you say, who touched you? yes, I'm looking for that specific person who touched me today. It was different. And what happened? And he looked around to see her who had done this thing. God says, there you are. I found you. There you are, young lady. There you are, woman. I know you. I know what you've been through. And I know what happened to you. I'm telling you, I found you. And the woman made a different response. The woman, fearing and trembling, knowing what happened to her. Why? Because she's going to be persecuted. A lot of people will ridicule her again, put her into outcast again for 12 long years, came and fell down before him and told him the whole truth. She was so afraid of what will the people tell her. Balik na naman doon. Hindi tao. Friends, magaling na ako, magaling na ako. Huwag mo na akong palayasin. Tanggapin niyo na ako. Magaling na ako ngayon. She was so fearful, but Jesus says, I found you. I found you. And Jesus said to her, daughter, your faith has made you well. Go in peace and be healed of your affliction. Immediately, she was declared healed. Suddenly, all the years of her affliction, suddenly everything is erased. Because Jesus found her. I see you. I know what you did. And right now, we may be in that situation. Lord, 2 years lang naman yung pinagdaanan ko, Lord. Pero Lord, hirap buhay ko, Lord. Lord, ang daming tao sa mundo, Lord. Millions of millions, billions of millions, billions, Lord. Praying to you, asking for help to you. Lord, paano mo ako makikita? Paano mo ako mararamdaman? Paano mo ako sasalubungin ngayon sa pinagdadaanan ko, Lord? I have a different past, Lord. A past, Lord, that not even my parents might not accept today if I tell it to them. Lord God, have you been sick, deceased? Oh, ew, Lord. Lord, how could you just see me today? And just what strikes Jesus the most, because Jesus notices people who praise him. That's what the woman did. She just praised God. She just praised God. And saw her immediately, just like a little child. Whew. Powerful. Hallelujah. And right now, Jesus is in this place. Do you believe that? Jesus is in this place. And today, we're not going to miss this moment because Jesus is in this place. And whatever you're going through out there, whatever past you've been through, whatever affliction you've been going through with your family, relationship, someone needs healing today. Someone needs a miracle today. You have an impossibility today. Guess what? Jesus is here. And we're not going to miss this moment today. We're going to praise him that God may notice our lives. God may notice our situation. God, Jesus, may notice our church. And he will just say, I found you. I found you. You're safe now. And I'm going to bring you to the greatest moments of your life. And this is what we're going to do today. Can we just come here in front? It's the last Sunday of the year. And today, we're just going to praise God. Amen. We're just going to praise God. Sige po, palakpakan po natin ang Panginoon. And I invite you to come here in the altar. hinihintayaan mong mapansin ng Panginoon ang papuri mo sa Kanya ngayon. And as the praise and worship team sings here, you may come here in front and we're gonna praise His holy name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Kurarapas sa kandaras. Yes, you may come.
Worship His holy name.
Let your praise be heard. Let your hearts, your cries be heard today.
Sing
Hallelujah.
Like never before. My soul, I worship your holy name. Bless the Lord, my soul. My soul, worship His holy name.
Want to praise, you may come here in front.
Sing like
Jesus is inviting
before.
You today.
Oh, my soul.
He's looking for you.
I worship
He's looking
your
for you. He's looking for people
name.
Who's going to praise Him. Hallelujah.
Bless the Lord, oh my soul. Oh, my soul. Worship His holy name. Like never before. Oh, my soul, I worship your holy name. Bless the Lord, bless the Lord, oh, my soul. Oh, my soul, worship His holy name. Sing
You're still
like
there. God is waiting for you. He wants to do something with your life today. Hallelujah, Jesus. Jesus, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord, oh my soul. Oh, my soul.
Let's worship. Worship God.
Sing like never before. Oh, my worship His holy name. Sing like never before. Oh, my soul, I worship Your holy name. Bless the Lord, bless the Lord, oh, my soul. Oh, my soul, worship His holy name. Within our hearts. Come in, church, if you want to join us in worship God. You may stand up if He leads you to stand up and worship Him. Come on, church. You can show this gratitude to Him. Go on and stand up and praise His name. Praise His holy name, because He's here right now. His presence is here right now. Come on, church. Come on, church, and let's stand up and praise Jesus. And as we sing this song once again, we sing it from our hearts. Only with our voices we sing. Bless the Lord, bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul, worship His holy name. Come in, church, you can sing it louder for Jesus. Sing like never before. Oh my soul, I worship Your holy. We can sing it louder for Him. Come on, church, with voices. Bless the Lord, oh my soul. Worship Your holy name. Praise the Lord, bless the Lord, oh my soul. Oh my soul, worship His holy name. Sing like never before. Oh my soul, I worship Your holy.
Everybody to come here in front.
Be glorified.
Let us praise God today.
Your
let us come here in front. Let us praise Him. Let us let Jesus, the greatness of this church. For this church is not a monument. It's a movement. God is moving in this church. Let us just invite you entirely and come here in front. Sir Howard, come here in front. And we're going to praise God.
Be glorified. Glorify Your name. We glorify Your name. We glorify Your name in all the earth. Jesus, praise is Yours. The highest praise. Is Your the highest
Healed. Today I declare you are restored. Today you are accepted already. You are received. You're not an outcast anymore. Because I found you. I found you, says the Lord. I found you today because of your worship. I found you. Tomorrow, later, you don't need to worry about your finances anymore. You don't need to worry about your building anymore. You don't need to worry about your family anymore. You don't need to worry about your past or your future. Why? Because I found you. I found you. And you're safe in my hands. Not only that, I'm gonna bring you to the greatest experiences you've ever lived because I found you. Hallelujah, Lord Jesus. Like we just raise up our hands today to the Lord. Lord Jesus, you see these hands, Lord. We are in surrender, God. Oh Jesus, here we are, Lord. Because you said you are here. And here we are, Lord. As we raise up our hands, God, we receive you in our lives. We allow you, Lord, to carry us through all the storms, all the fire, all the flood. Here we are, God. And you are taking notice of our hearts today. You are taking notice of everything today. Hallelujah. 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 Jesus, we praise you, Lord. Praise you, Lord. Hallelujah. 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 Sing a song. Hallelujah. You sing these words. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Sing this to you, God. Hallelujah. 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 Something great. Hallelujah, God. Hallelujah, Jesus. And if you just pray this prayer with me today, say this with all our hearts, with all our hearts of praise. Lord Jesus Christ.
Lord Jesus Christ.
I have faith in you.
I have faith in you.
And nothing is impossible for you, God.
Nothing is impossible for you.
You've proven it today.
You've proven it today.
You've proven it yesterday.
You've proven it yesterday.
You've proven it last month.
You've proven it last month.
You've proven it last year.
You've proven it last year.
You've proven it all the days of my life.
You've proven it all the days of my life.
And I put my faith on you.
And I put my faith in you.
And I would just like to give you thanks.
And I would just like to give you thanks.
Or thank you.
Lord, thank you.
Thank you for this life.
Thank you for this life.
Thank you for this family.
Thank you for this family.
Thank you for this church.
Thank you for this church.
Thank you, Lord God, for everything.
Thank you, Lord God, for everything.
Thank you for this whole year.
Thank you for this whole year.
It may not be perfect.
It may not be perfect.
But we're at the end of it.
But we're at the end of it.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
And Lord Jesus Christ.
And Lord Jesus Christ.
My praise. Doesn't stop.
Stop.
Today. It's only the beginning. Of my wholehearted praise for you.
Of my wholehearted praise for you.
And I believe.
Today.
Tomorrow.
Next week.
Next year.
All the rest of my life. All the rest of my life.
You're gonna take notice of me.
You're gonna take notice of me.
Because I will praise you.
Because I will praise you.
All the days.
Of my life.
And thank you, Lord. For finding me again. I'm safe in your hands. The great moments, Lord. Are with you. Hallelujah. Just give God a very best clap offering. Let's give God our very best praise. Let's say hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. God bless you, everyone. Before we end, can we just raise up our tithes and offering to God? This is our act of praise to Him. The last Sunday that we're going to give our tithes to God, and we're going to make it count. We're going to give it our very best.
Hallelujah, what a wonderful time to praise. What a wonderful time to worship. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord. And could all of us right now, could you just please stand up and let us raise up our tithes and offering to God. Sige po, tayo po lahat ay tumayo. Before we close the service, let's worship Him with our tithes and offering. Lord Jesus, Lord, thank you, Lord God, for everything, God. And Lord God, we don't want to praise money, Lord. Never, God, never. I don't want to praise money. That's why we lift it up to you, Lord God. Because it's, Lord God, we will not give our best to earn money, Lord. We will give our best only to you. Because when we give our very best, just put our feet, just give these things, just praise you. Wow. The best is yet to come in our lives. And we give you our love today, our worship. This is our all. We give it to you. And Lord Jesus Christ, Lord God, you never fail us. Today, you didn't just took notice. Didn't you just take notice of the people here? Lord, you took notice of this church. You took notice of Church of God, Marriott Manila. You took notice of Church of God, Philippines, Lord. Because our praise never stops. As long as we live, we give you our praise. Hallelujah, Lord. And Lord God, thank you for this wonderful time. And let's just continue to praise you, Lord God, today, tomorrow, next week, the whole year next, Lord. And we just worship you. We just worship you, and we have faith that you are moving in this place, in our lives. Thank you for this Christmas day. Lord God, let us have a wonderful day, wonderful week with our families, and a wonderful 2017. We claim the victory, and we give you back all the glory and all the praise in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen and amen. God bless everyone. Hallelujah, hallelujah. And before you leave, pwede bang yakapin mo naman yung katabi mo? You could just roam around. The kids will be singing here today. And you could just greet one another with a Merry Christmas. You could thank your family members, your friends today. God bless everyone.
God bless you, church.
Happy song, medyo happy. Go, go.